The OAI PMH Harvester allows users to load objects into Rosetta directly from an OAI PMH digital repository. It has two modes of operation: loading new objects into Rosetta and updating objects already existing in Rosetta. In this session, we will demonstrate how to load new objects into Rosetta using the OAI PMH Harvester job. In our example, we're migrating content to Rosetta from Digitool, a digital content management system. You might have a different originating system. Let's take a look at the published OAI records from Digitool. These are the actual records we will load into Rosetta. Each record contains all the DC metadata, and additionally, you will notice that we have a DC identifier field that contains the full path to the content file that is to be loaded into Rosetta. Our Rosetta workflow begins by running the OAI PMH Harvester job, which creates SIP packages on a mount folder based on the published records. You can choose to create the SIPs in either METS or Dublin Core format. Next, we run a submission job to ingest the content into Rosetta and complete the workflow. Both jobs can be scheduled so that the migration process runs autonomously. So let's, for example, run a METS ingestion using the OAI PMH Harvester job. Here in the Rosetta Management module, let's first see how the OAI PMH Harvester job is configured and then run it to create the SIP package. Under Deposits, OAI Harvester Job, you will need to create your own job by clicking Add Job. So let's take a look at an existing job so you can see the necessary configurations. Under Scheduling, you can define how often the job should run. And under Job Parameters, the base URL is the OAI server, in our case Digitool, where our published records can be found. Once you fill this in, Rosetta automatically populates the drop-down lists for existing sets and metadata prefixes. Under Match, select the ID type to prevent duplicate records. Under XSL file, we select the XSL that defines the transformation of the record from its original format to Rosetta METS or Dublin Core. We will soon see how to configure this XSL. If this field is left empty, the default XSL that transforms to DC is selected. In our example, we use the OAI Dublin Core to Rosetta METS transformation, and accordingly, under Material Flow, we select a METS Material Flow. The material flow is needed because under its submission format, it provides the mount folder where the resultant SIP packages of this job are placed. When we configure our submission job, we will use the same material flow. In the test area, you can run a transformation on a sample record in the OAI server and review the resultant METS or DC XML. Optionally, we can receive an email to inform us of the success or failure of this job. We can click Run Now to run the harvest immediately. But before that, let's see the configurations of the XSL file and material flow used by this job. The XSL file can be found under Deposits, OAI Harvester Transformation. Here you can find existing out-of-the-box XSLs, or you can create your own by clicking Add File. We are using this XSL, OAIDC2METS.XSL. You'll recall when we saw the published OAI record, the path of the content file was found under the DC identifier XML element. So here in the file section of the METS, we use the value of the DC identifier element as the full path to the content file. For a refresher on METS, you can refer to the Rosetta METS Deposit Workflow session. Let's now view the material flow under Deposit Material Flows. You can create your own material flows or edit existing ones. In our example, we're using the out-of-the-box Rosetta METS Deposit Material Flow. Note that in our case, the content structure is METS. You may be using DC. And importantly, here is the submission format that contains the target path of the SIP packages. So let's view it under Deposit Submission Format. Here is our submission format. And here is the NFS path where the SIP package will be placed by the OAI Harvester job for the submission job to find. Having seen the relevant configurations, now let's manually run the OAI job. Go to Deposits, OAI Harvester Job, and for your job, click Run Now. So this is the step we just ran, and now we should have our SIP packages waiting on the mount. So let's take a look at our mount. We are in our FTP client, and here is the same path we provided in the submission format. We can see that our harvester job has created one or more folders with a timestamp in the name. Each folder represents one SIP. Rosetta generates one SIP for every OAI PMH response. If the OAI PMH server returns a resumption token, another request is sent and another SIP is generated from each subsequent response. The number of IEs depends on the number of records returned per response. Looking at the SIP folder, we can see the content folder with which we are familiar from the Mets workflow. Inside the content folder, we can find the IEs. Notice that there is no streams folder, since each IE XML file contains direct links to the content files. The content files themselves are not yet stored here. They will be downloaded using the links during the submission job. So now that our SIP package is ready, let's look at the configuration of the submission job and run it. Back in Rosetta, under Deposits Submission Job, here you will create your own job similar to the one we will now see. In the Scheduling section, you will typically schedule your job to run after the corresponding OAI Harvester job. Under Material Flow, make sure to select the same material flow you used in the corresponding OAI Harvester job. Let's manually run this submission job. Looking at our diagram, this is the step we've just run. And back at the submission job page under Job History, we can see the log of our run and the status of the SIPs ingested. And viewing the log, we can quickly find the SIP IDs. Let's copy the ID. And as always, we can search our operational repository for the SIP. Show in Workbench. And click Work On to see the IEs of our SIP. And we can click View to see the material. Thanks for joining us.